Our presidential election now 35 days away. Election fraud still posing a dangerous threat to this democracy, perhaps even worsening. Early voting began today in Ohio after the state Supreme Court there ruled that absentee voters could register and cast their ballots on the same day. As Kitty Pilgrim now reports, that new law could lead to massive election fraud in that critical swing state.
You're here to vote? Let's go vote. They open up early.
In Ohio today, new rules allow one-stop voting. From now until October 6th, new voters can register to vote and cast an absentee ballot at the same time. But how can all those new registrations be checked before the votes are counted?
There's a great opportunity for people who otherwise shouldn't be allowed to vote to be able to cast a ballot. And we think that with the crush of other election activities that are going on in Ohio, that it'll be that the Board of Elections workers, we think they're going to be hard-pressed to get through and take care of all of the verification.
No photo ID is required. New Ohio voters have only to write down the last four digits of their Social Security number or write down their driver's license number. They can also register with a utility bill, cell phone bill, bank statement, or paycheck, even college ID if those documents include name and address. Ohio Secretary of State, Democrat Jennifer Brunner, changed the rules on absentee voting by directive.
There wasn't anything voted on. The General Assembly did not vote on this. The people's representatives did not vote on this. She issued a directive and said, this is the way it's going to be. That's the reason why we had to sue in court.
The Republicans lost their suit against the rule in the Ohio Supreme Court. They charged the Democratic Secretary of State changed the rules to usher in scores of new voters for presidential candidate Barack Obama. She denies the charge. The Secretary of State's office estimates that a quarter of all votes cast in this election, more than 1.5 million, will be absentee ballots.
Now, Secretary of State Brunner's office today said there are safeguards for checking the registration of new voters. They're satisfied with the proof of identity requirements. But critics say election boards are unprepared to register and check this quantity of new voters just before an important election, Lou.
Has everybody lost their minds? There's no way for these volunteers to check that. I mean, it's an absurdity.
Yeah, the officials we spoke to today say that the county boards are just overwhelmed with the volume that they have to do at this point. This is such a big election.
Well, it is a big election, important election, but apparently no one cares about that. Kitty, thank you very much. Kitty Pilgrim.